Hello and welcome to this demonstration video about the Bucher & Suter reporting package for CUIC. So what is the reporting package for CUIC? So our reporting package is built on the CUIC platform itself. So what we do is we are gonna enhancing the CUIC platform with additional templates for reporting. These templates are used for real-time and as well historical reports. The package also leverages the existing CUIC features. For example, we can build up a multi-tenancy enabled reporting tool. We have advanced filter capabilities to filter and nail down to each individual call. We have the possibility to export these reports into Excel. We can also use the reporting scheduler so that a supervisor gets an email every morning with the performance of the last day, for example. And we can also edit the whole report. So that means we can add and remove columns. We can also rename them or put some thresholds behind. Besides that, we can also use the graphics within CUIC. So that means we can create pie charts, line diagrams, bar graphs, gauges, and so on. Of course, all of these reports can also be used within the CUIC dashboard. So at a glance, what is the reporting package bringing? So on the one hand side, we can drill down into the reporting details. So that means we can show, for example, one line is 1 week of a contact center performance, one line could be even a day, or one line can be a 15 minutes interval. And from there, we can even drill down into the call detail records. So that means to each individual call. Using the advanced filters, we are able to filter out or filter in on specific calls or emails or chats. So that means, for example, where the service level was very bad or the waiting time was very long, these kind of calls or events can be filtered and can be analyzed. The reporting package is able to report on all channels. So that means we can report on chat, email, and voice in parallel. So we have one platform for an omnichannel reporting. The reports are available for historical reasons, but as well, we can also use the real-time graphs and build up real-time dashboards. The data can also be exported either through the front end, so that means either an export to Excel, or through the scheduler to send out an email to a certain person with the reporting data, or even accessible via SQL, so that means giving access to the core data on the database. There's a very big online help available. This help is very useful in order to understand each of the KPIs. The Bucher-Suter reporting package consists of two packages. One is called the basic, the other one is called the call-by-call package. Within the basic, here in the graph below the blue part, we have multiple reports. We have reports about the agent teams, about the skills, the precision queues, the call types, and so on. There, we also have the possibility to make the drill downs. So that means that we can present an individual time interval per line. On top of that, we do have the call-by-call reporting. So the call-by-call means there you're gonna see every single call with which reached the contact center or every single email. The basic package has its smallest interval for 15 minutes. So that means one line in the report represents a 15-minute interval. In the call-by-call, we can drill down to the details. Here are now some examples of what we can do from the reporting perspective in real time. So here we can see different kinds of graphics. For example, a line diagram for the service level, a bar chart, a pie, and so on. Of course, we can also set thresholds. For example, if a certain value is too high, then we can display it in a different color as an example. These dashboards can also be placed within Finesse. Here, this is an example of the agent desktop, where the agent desktop has access to a dashboard showing the performance of the contact center in real time. Of course, these dashboards can also be presented on a wallboard. So that means using a PC and a big monitor and calling in a website of CUIC in order to display such information. This is an example of a call-by-call report. So here in the call-by-call, you can see every single detail of a report. You can see even the phone number of the customer, the waiting time, the hold times, the handle times, and even who from the contact center worked on the certain call. There's the possibility to have also the omnichannel reports. For example, through call types, we are able to report in the omnichannel environment. So that means we can bring up one report that shows voice calls with the certain amount of offered, answered, and abandoned, then the chats in this one, and the emails in that one. Here, for example, it's split it up for the 15 minutes interval, and in the bottom we find the total overall. Let's have a look on the online help, which is very extensive. If you go to the Buchholz-Hütter website, you find a section called the CUIC reports. On this section, there you can find more information about all reports and its details. Let's dig into the details. We do have an online help on this website. When you open up the online help, first of all, you see an explanation of how and where the reporting KPIs are going to be counted. So how to set the call types, how to use and report on skill groups and agents. You even find information of how something is counted. So you can see when is a call offered, when is it called queued, when is it answered, when is it handled, and so on. Let's have a view on some of the reports here in the online help. If we go to the call type section, we will see all available templates of the CUIC Buchholz-Hütter reporting. If we open up, for example, this template, we first of all see a screenshot of some sample data and some sample graphics, and then we find a whole description of the fields and even for these fields, how they are calculated, if there's a formula behind. Here's an example, for example, how the availability is calculated. Each of these reports has a drill down. So when you go into the details here, you can find a drill down where you can get from that report to a second report, which gonna gives you, for example, the intraday staffing, in different kind of graphics, and below even again the field description of what does which field mean. These were now examples for real-time reports. Let's have a look on some historical reports. On the historical reports, for example, we have a daily performance report. So the daily performance report gives you information about what has been answered, abandoned, and how good have we been, even from the service level perspective. Again, also here, we see the different views as some examples, and then there, the details of each of these KPI numbers. Something which is new and not existing in the standard CUIC is enterprise call types. So enterprise call types are used in order to group multiple call types into one call type. So for example, if you have an organization and you have 10 different normal call types, you can group them together and report as one enterprise call type. The enterprise call type is really a big help in order to summarize multiple details of the contact center from the call type perspective. Let's have a view on the team. So we do have some statistics about the agent team. So for example, from how many people are ready and not ready in real time, as well how many people are logged in per team. So such information we can find on the team space as well. Last but not least, let's have a look for the call by call templates. As I explained before, the call by call gives you a single line for every report. So this single line can be, for example, one single chat, one single email, or one single voice call. Within here, you can find the whole details and even who handled what kind of call. You're also able to find recallers and the persons of recallers and why do they recall. Again, everything is available on our website, so you don't need to log in, you can simply browse through the online help. Let's come to a demo and I'm going to show you some of these reports in action. This is the CUIC front end from Cisco. Within CUIC, you have the possibility to create different kind of reports from real time and historical, as well as you can create dashboards. Let's start with some dashboards. In dashboards, you have the possibility to create an overview of real-time information, and this overview you can publish on any screen on any HTTP website. As well, they are also accessible from Finesse if necessary. These dashboards are going to be created by a supervisor manually. And that's quite easy. You simply go into the edit mode, and you can add a new report. You simply select what kind of report you would like to see. For example, you want to see information about, let's go for calls handled in the last half hour. And there you go. Of course, you can also add other things, for example, a complete table, as we have it in an example over here. Let's go to some of the reports. When you go to the report section, you're gonna see the Buchholz-Suter reporting package in here. As we learned, it consists of two packages, the basic and the call by call. Again, the basic is holding all real-time and historical reports up to a 15-minute interval. So that means one line represents the last 15 minutes. The call by call goes into the details. Let's go into the basic first. There you see a section of templates what you have for each of these reports. Let's go for call types. In here, you find the standard templates. These are coming from our reporting package. So when you open up one, you're going to be asked, what do you want to report in this real-time report? So here, you can make a filter. You can, if you want, add an additional filter. For example, if you only want to see a certain extent of numbers with this formula. Or you can simply go ahead and show everything. So when you show everything, you can see, for example, in this report on the voice currently, there's nothing in queue. Emails, we do have something in queue. And for chat, there's also nothing in queue. You also see the service levels and so on. So in here, you can even then go ahead and you can export this report. So if you want to export it, you can export, of course, real-time and historical reports, and they will open up an Excel for that. You can also change the filter if necessary in order to find the correct data. Let's have a look on another report. Let's talk about a historical report. So this report gives you the possibility to report in the historical data. So you can select here a time range, for example, these ones, or you can even customize them. You can say from a certain day and time frame. And of course, you can go ahead and extract a different time range. For example, let's make a report only for the business hours and not for the night, and the same also for the weekdays. Let's select again the call types we want to report. Again, also here you can add an individual filter on all of the fields available. And there we go. There you see now what has been done on the chat part, on the email, and on the voice for each of the days, what has been answered, what has abandoned, and so on. There you find even the service level in within. And then you can get into the details. For example, if you see the service level is not accurate, you can go from here into the details. And there you see what happens in detail. Let's leave the call types and let's have a look into the team. So in Team, for example, we can also show up a real-time report. And there we see information about real-time, in this case for this team. So let's have a look on the intraday staffing report, which is a historical one. We select the team. And there you see what happened today from the headcount perspective. Let's come to the last section, the call by call. So if I go to call by call, I have different possibilities to report on call by calls. Let's have a look on this report. So we have to select the time range. adding additional filter if necessary, and run the report. So now here we see the details of what has been done on contacts, and if I'm interested in, I can dive into the detail here. And there you see every single call with its ARNI. Was it a voice call or an email? You see all the timers, the talk time, the hold times, and so on. And there even you see who worked on this certain voice call as an example. If the calls have been transferred, you also see who was working on doing the transfers and what was the last target. Thank you for watching this demonstration video.